In a final attempt to help you understand all of this, I'm going to show you an animation that was put together by a former student of mine, Dr. Ardavan Padram. Here is the memory hierarchy. And at the bottom there, we have the matrix-matrix multiply that we would like to perform. And notice that matrix A is partitioned into column panels and matrix B into row panels. Now, to compute C equals A times B plus C, we can do these computations. Now, if we look at how to implement one of these effectively, we want to partition this column panel of A into blocks and then compute row panels of C. That's animated as follows. In order to now compute one of those row panels of C, we do a block of A times these little slivers of B updating a sliver of C. Each of those slivers is of width 4 in our discussion a second ago. Now, what happens is that block of A is brought into the L2 cache, and we want to do a blocked A times a sliver of B to update a sliver of C. And that's illustrated here. Now, in the process here, we actually transpose matrix A. So instead of doing our inner products by rows of A, we're doing them by columns of A. So now let's see how we depict how we utilize the L2 and L1 caches and the registers. Well, the block of A is brought into the L2 cache and transposed along the way. The sliver of B ends up in the L1 cache. In this particular example, four elements of C end up in registers. We looked at a 4x4 block before. And now, every time we bring in an element of A out of the L2 cache, we do 8 floating point operations, 4 multiplies and 4 adds to update 4 elements of C. Once we're done with those 4 elements of C, the next 4 elements of C come in, and we do the next update. So this depicts where and when what data is in order to do as we do our slicing and dicing.